Oh, hey. What's up? What am I doing? I'm getting ready for Kids Online. Oh, we've already started. Oh, hey! Welcome to Kids Online. That was a fun game, wasn't it? We were searching for different things in each of those pictures. I was actually doing some searching myself, you know, searching for truth, getting ready for Kids Week with my Kids Week shovel. But I don't think this is probably the best way to do it. So I'm gonna put this stuff away because today we're learning about how the gospel brings all different types of people together. That's what the church is. And my friend Martha is gonna help us talk about that. Well, before that, let's get into some worship. Parents, grab your parent guide in the description box below. Stand on up and on the count of three. You ready to say hit it? Cool. 1, 2, 3, hit it.
Set us free. Your mighty name will ever be. the soundtrack of our victory. We're lifting up your praise like a battle cry. The thunder of your name breaks apart the night. Your matchless grace will ever be the soundtrack of our victory.
Paul wrote a letter to the church at Ephesus. He reminded them of the wonderful blessings people have when they belong to Jesus. This is what Paul said. Before you knew Jesus, you were dead in your sins. You used to live like the world, like those who choose to disobey God. We all live like that, doing whatever felt right to us. But God, who is full of mercy because of his great love that he had for us, made us alive with Christ. We were spiritually dead, and he gave us life. You were saved by grace. Then Paul explained what else God has done for everyone who trusts in Jesus. God raised us up with Christ and gave us a seat with him in the heavens. This way, he can show us grace and kindness both now and for all time. For you are saved by grace through faith. And this is not from yourselves. It is God's gift, not from works, so that no one can boast. We are God's masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus to do the good works God has prepared for us to do. Paul reminded the Ephesians that they were Gentiles, not Jews. You were born outside of God's chosen people. You were not part of Israel. You didn't know God, and you had no hope, he said. But now, Jesus has brought you into God's family by dying on the cross. Before, Jews and Gentiles were separated by hate. Paul said, Jesus is our peace. Bringing together Jews and Gentiles is one group. You aren't strangers anymore. You are all members of God's household, and Jesus holds this house together. This was why Paul was a prisoner. He dedicated his life to sharing the good news of Jesus with Gentiles. God called Paul to this work so all people, Jews and Gentiles, would know that they are members of the same body, partners in the promises of Jesus. The gospel brings together all people who have faith in Jesus. God's salvation is a gift of grace, not something we can earn with good works. Forgiven sinners come together as the church to obey God and do His work in the world.
Together, 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 everyone. Together, together. Whoa, come on, let's have some fun. Oh my God, gumdrops. How long have you been? Hey guys, absolutely did not see you there. I'm Martha and this is my friend Mr. Potato Head. I was just singing one of my favorite songs, We're All In This Together. It talks about joining together and being together, being together, okay? Hey, that kind of reminds me of our story this week. As we saw in the video, through God's sacrifice, believers are joined together in Christ. Just like Mr. Potato Head here, we are all a part of the same family, making up different parts of the body of Christ. Some are the baseball cap, others eyeballs, and the hands, and the feet, and the, I think you get the idea. Is this the nose?
Yes.
What I'm trying to say is us believers all have different gifts, talents, passions, and we may even live in different parts of the world, but we are brought together under the family of Christ through the good news. The gospel is the good news. It brings together all people who have faith in Jesus. God sent His Son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sake. This is a gift of grace, and it's not something that we can earn with good works. We're not perfect, we're going to sin, but we have the joy of turning to the Father to ask for forgiveness. In these moments, we can come together as the church to obey God and do His work in the world. Paul lived his life sharing the gospel. He admitted that he was far from perfect, but he highlighted what God had done in his life to bring others into the family of Christ. Who is someone in your life that needs to hear this good news? Do you think that you could go around and love others so well that they can't help but see that Jesus is in you and that is Him shining through? Hey, you could even invite someone to Kids Week to share the good news with them. Y'all, take this week and think to yourself, how can I go about sharing the good news of Christ? We look forward to hearing your ideas and we cannot wait to see you next time.
The church is a place where all people, no matter what they look like, they sound like, or what they're interested in, can meet and be together. The gospel unites people that are all different together. We really get to see this when we meet at church every week. Hey, maybe you've never visited us at one of our campuses. We'd love to meet you, and I want to personally invite you. Come be a part of our Mercy Hill family. You can visit Mercy Hill Church .com if you want to find out our summer serve times. And we're so excited for you to join us that when you get here, we'll even have a gift for you. We'd even love to see you join us as we dig for truth at Kids Week. But before we go, remember, the most exciting life is one lived for Jesus. So go live that exciting life Jesus has for you together with others, and we'll see you next week.
Oh, swag. Okay. Bless you. Did you sneeze?
Yeah.
Oh my goody gumdrops. Hi guys. I can't do it. Okay, so scroll. Yeah. Oh no. Down. Right. No. Up. Keep going. Up. Stop. Hold. Incredible. Oh goodness. You're sent out. See ya. Seriously, see ya. Bye. Have a great week. Okay, bye.